What's going on, everybody? Cars and Cigars here. Coming at you, I'm going to do another humidor tour. Now, the last humidor tour that I did do, I've since gotten rid of that humidor. And I've transferred a lot of the cigars that were in that one into my newest one. And now, we're going to go through that one. Tell you how I like it, what I don't like about it, you know, things like that, things of that nature. So go ahead and get this show on the road. Hey. That's the humidor. So a lot of these trays are the same. I've gotten pretty much all the same stuff from that previous one. These are good. These are good. So that's all in there. See if we can get some of the stuff I didn't have. Maybe down in this drawer. Little chair here. Get this a little more steady. Alright, so got a few of these Hoyos. Hoyo de Monterey Epicures. Got a few five packs of those. Sorry for keeping the camera trained on not what I'm doing a video about. Yeah, these things happen. Got one of these, basically just a gag. I mean, it is a real cigar, it can be smoked. There's people that have smoked them. But it's made by Oscar, so it's probably a really good smoke. But anywho, so yeah, got a lot of the same stuff. Vegas 5-4 pack. Let's see, some Boulevards. Get that out of the way. Got a diesel bundle because I love diesel cigars. I got a bundle of the Olivia Proteges, Super Premium Seconds. Those are really good cigars. Don't ever let anybody tell you different. They really are. I think they're made in the same factory as like the Hoyos and Punch and stuff like that. Got this drawer. Bunch of Asylums in there. And more Asylums. Young Gigantes. Got a drawer full of them. Leftovers of those. Move my modifier thingy. It's a control panel. Okay, so got a whole drawer of some Cinco Vegas. Another good smoke. Don't let anybody tell you different. That's kind of a mixed bag. That's Grey Cliffs. Some Macanudo. Inspirados. And some Cuba Libre 1s. Those are good too. some Oreos, premium Ortega cigars. Not bad, pretty good too. Let's see, got some Romeos, some CAOs. And down here, it's got some bunch of randoms. This is all the stuff from the last video. Some John Box's Bulls. So I'm thinking what we're going to do is we're going to make this a short one, a short humidor tour, since you already saw a lot of what I had in the last video. And I'm going to call that a video. Basically, I guess you could just call it a tour of the humidor. This humidor, I got a really good deal on it. It had a hygrometer, an analog hygrometer in there. I took that out, just covered it up. There was another spot of leakage. You can see I had to do foam. Is this thing had a horrible seal on it. I mean horrible, it wouldn't keep humidity for nothing. And with that thicker foam, I took the, this big cigar. Take a drag of this one. You can enjoy a cigar in your house and not have to worry about it. Don't have to worry about it one bit. Puts it right outside. Doesn't even give it a chance to stick around in your house. There you go. Those latches are the same window latches I had on my that smaller humidor that I did in the humidor tour, the previous one. You need those because that expanding foam, it all the way down, all around the door, it puts a lot of pressure when it expands. It puts a lot of pressure pushing out, so the standard lock will not hold it at all. You have to do something about it. So these are a fantastic option. The humidor itself, it's okay. I mean, you know, it's doing its job. It's definitely one of those that you have to seal up. I haven't checked around the glass, but the glass I did look at the door both sides. It looks like it's got a pretty good seal. So I'm really not worried about that. too much. And that was at 67 when I opened it. So, see how fast it takes it to climb back up. Yeah, see? It's doing pretty good so far. My other concern with this was around all along the top. It's like this is a tube. There's a giant hole. I'm not going to open it again, but up in the center there's a giant hole cut out that leads into this section. Now this whole section is just open in there. And I haven't gotten around to it, but I was thinking of throwing some sealant all the way around the thing, front, back, side to side, and maybe seeing if that would help with the maintaining the humidity inside, because I don't know if it's a leak. This was definitely so. Good old sticker came in handy to cover that thing up. But other than that, you know, it's for the price, it's a decent humidor. I mean, it comes with adjustable shelves. You know, got a pretty solid bottom. Got good drawer space, good storage down there for your boxes. I also have a humidifier down there also. So all in all, it's a decent humidor for the money. I mean, yeah, it's cheap. You're gonna have to, you know, put some effort into helping it maintain a seal. But yeah. Outside of that, you get it sealed up, you get the problem spots taken care of and fixed, and it's a decent humidor. I haven't added any lighting to it at all. I probably won't. I mean, just because it's just kind of a, in all reality, this is just my overflow. You know, this is all overflow. This is just a spot. I got tired of keeping the big old plastic tubs around and taking up space for that. I had to do something. So this was it was under $1,000 with shipping. So I can't complain too bad about that. Now the next tour that I do, I think I'm finally going to get around to doing this one. And then once I do that one, right over here, I'll do this one. So, yeah. Dog bone. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed that little tour. I know that one's kind of a mess right now. So, I don't know. I'll get around to straightening up. I don't know if I'm going to put any lights in it. What I'm going to do. Probably just leave it alone. I put so much effort and work into the other two. It's just kind of like this one's kind of like the bastard child. So, probably just leave it alone. Leave it as it is. We've done enough. So, anyway, hope you enjoyed that video. Hope I was somewhat informative on that humidor, some of the problem spots with it. Yeah. Any questions? Try to be as helpful as I can. Sorry for the pause, but I was just having a thought. I'm wondering if I could restain that to kind of match the other two. Instead of being that bright, ugly red. It's not really ugly. It does kind of stand out like a sore thumb, though. I don't know. I'll figure it out later. Anyways, hope you enjoyed that. Hopefully it was helpful. And again, if you have any questions about anything, just drop them in the comments. Go ahead and ask me. I'll see if I can help you as much as possible. Other than that, talk to you guys later. Thanks.